Hi guys, Alex here. Today I'm talking about a VR training company called Immerse. They have launched their SDK to the market for free. So I spoke with Justin Parry, COO and co-founder of Immerse, to learn more.
So the SDK is targeted at any company creating VR content for enterprise, essentially. So specifically focused on training and employee experience, but really anything in there, any use case you like. Whether it's hard skills, soft skills, whatever the use case, you know, whatever the industry. Yeah. At the moment, the SDK we've got is entirely focused on Unity. We're looking at Unreal in terms of support, but the vast majority of companies that we talk to are using Unity. If you were to talk to one of those companies, I think the problem number one that they would probably tell you is winning business. The industry is growing all the time. There will be more and more opportunities. There is a real need at the moment to look at the time and cost of development. That's from a customer perspective. Obviously, they always want a good price, but it's also in terms of your own internal ability to deliver content more efficiently to either optimize your margins or bring down the price that you're passing on to your customer. Time and cost. Big thing. We're seeing companies that have increasingly built an app, piloted it, got fantastic results, and are now going, hey, we want to scale this thing. So if you're one of those smaller companies and your customer comes to you with that kind of proposition, it's a bit problematic because you're a content company and you don't have the internal tech capabilities or maybe the desire or money to build the kind of solution that's needed to sort of turn the dial up and scale content, both in terms of lots of applications, lots of users, lots of use cases, all being standardized and consolidated into a single place. Flip side of that is that there are lots of instances where big companies have already built lots of apps and they've got lots of vendors, but they've all been spun up by different parts of the business, right? So 20 different departments have done 20 different projects. And that company then has to work out how they're going to bring all those things together. So then each of those vendors is either having to integrate independently on a case-by-case basis, which is not sensible at all, not cost-effective, not sustainable, or they need to bring their applications into an overarching sort of platform. So all of that said, as well as that speeding up the time of delivery and reducing the cost through these kind of standardized interaction libraries and other features, there's also the option to switch on this enterprise platform for your customers. And we have lots of companies coming to us with that problem saying, we've got this far with our customer, mm-hmm. They want to scale, we can't do it, we need your technology. So by providing the SDK up front, it means that they can start building content in a way that makes it really easy to switch all of those services on. If you're using our interaction library, we have an MPC system coming, we've got a UI framework, lots of other roadmap developments. If you're using all of that, how much does it speed things up? We see huge increases in productivity through developing these things for ourselves, right? So that's what we always do. We develop them for ourselves. If they help us, we assume they're going to help other people. On top of that, what greater opportunity does this afford me with this customer in terms of future content creation? If we can scale together, there will be more and more content creation opportunities for me further down the line. We're also interested in partnership opportunities with these content companies as well. So if they're using the SDK and they have a customer that wants to scale, then they can get some upside by becoming an Immerse partner. So if they can refer customers to us, there's obviously revenue opportunities in there for them. But there's also the fact that if they're using the SDK to create their content, and that content, they own the IP to that content, then we can look at ways that we can essentially monetize that existing content via our platform because it's been built on the SDK. So there's a big demand for off-the-shelf content, right? So things that you can just buy on a subscription basis, a license model. Lots of these smaller companies have built excellent content that is use case specific, regionally specific, and they own it. So we are creating a marketplace of this content, which we then sell on to our direct customers, but also to our prospects as well via a marketplace effectively. And often what happens is that when these smaller companies are creating content for a customer, they do get to keep the IP. So they own the content and they can do what they like with it. So as long as they take obviously the logos and stuff out, as you say, yes, they can resell that. Now, it may not be that is always the right content for the right customer, but mm-hmm. if 80% of it is right, then then customizing 20% is far cheaper than going to another organization and asking them to start from scratch. So the physics-based interaction library, for instance, the fact that makes multiplayer really easy to switch on, which is a really difficult thing to do. If you create a single player app and then you suddenly want to make it multiplayer, that is incredibly difficult. So this physics-based system that we've created there, that enables that. And then we're building an NPC system to make these non-player characters more easier to find and develop. And then, you know, a standardized UI framework, because menu systems are a bit of a nightmare and creating themes within those menu systems is really difficult. So all those things, these are all the sort of more the lower level content creation technical problems that we're solving. If you go to our website now, immerse.io, you can find the SDK there. It's at immerse.io/the Immerse SDK. Nice. And then from there, we link you out to the SDK documentation, and there's also a support forum as well.